Katie Berg, and I'm your host for Let's Talk Hypnosis. And today we have with us our very special guest, hypnotist and stage entertainer, Don Spencer. Welcome to the show.
Well, thank you for inviting me. How are you today?
I am fantastic, but I really want to tell our audience a little bit about you. So let me tell you a little bit about Don. Don Spencer is a sought-after speaker, entertainer, and trainer in the field of hypnosis, mind science, lie detection, and advanced communication skills. He's got over 30 years of practice in hypnosis and entertainment, boasting one of the longest-running shows for a consecutive 320 weeks. Don has also had the privilege of performing at events such as the 2002 Winter Olympics, and his hypnotic skills have taken him far and wide, giving him the pleasure of entertaining people like the Sheikh of Dubai around the world. So, Don, I often wonder, and you know I'm going to be taking your upcoming stage hypnosis training course, I often wonder, what is a life like where you get to travel around the world and perform, and but most of all, just make people laugh and have a good time?
Pretty cool. Two thumbs up. You know, it's always nice to be able to, you know, to travel anywhere in the world, all expenses paid, and be, you know, and you know, be a celebrity wherever you go on that kind of a playing field. So it's, you know, I call it the hypnotic lifestyle. You know, what the way that I approach it is I have a map on my wall, mm-hmm. and I just look at places that I want to visit that I've never gone to before, and I just project it out there, and then normally within a week or 2 weeks, I'll get a phone call or somebody will send me an email and they will say, Mr. Spencer, we've seen all your stuff and would like to know what it would take to get you to come do a presentation over here.
Wonderful, wonderful. So how did you first start entertaining in the first place? What moved you from being a hypnotherapist to an entertainer?
Boredom. You know, not just boredom. You know, I mean, when I first started doing hypnosis and hypnotherapy, my only goal was I just wanted to help people. I want people to feel better.
Right.
But before that, when I was living in San Diego, I was also actively involved in the movie industry. I started making some real movies that you'll never see ever, and commercials, and doing some modeling. And so I was, you know, working towards that field. And then my life kind of got turned upside down. I became a single dad with three kids all of a sudden. So I had to leave San Diego, went up to Idaho, and just started, you know, and I had I couldn't pursue my passion. So I had to pursue hypnosis because I was, you know, paying the bills. So I moved to Idaho, became a single dad, had three kids, raised them, and started teaching at the College of Southern Idaho for 4 years. And for the first 2 years of doing hypnotherapy, maybe 3 years, you know, most of the work that I did, I cut my teeth in this business working with things like multiple personality disorder and adult victims of early childhood sexual abuse and, you know, ritual abuse and pretty ugly stuff.
Yeah, no kidding.
It was kind of funny because, you know, I always wanted to do entertainment because it's kind of a natural thing for me. I like entertaining people. I like to have fun. And one day, you know, this guy came through town doing a show and at one of the local bars. And I remember going there and saying, why is he in my town? This is my town, not his. And it was like that. I said, you know what? I'm not going to let that happen again. So I just, you know, I developed a show. That's all I did. You know, I mean, I took some stage hypnosis training years ago with Orman McGill and at some various hypnosis conventions back in around 85, 86, 87. And, you know, so I just began to apply those. And because I had been teaching college for 4 years, my classes we usually had about, you know, 50 to 60 people in my class, and I taught, I think, three nights a week.
Wow. So there's your audience.
So not only was I teaching a lot of people, but I was also demonstrating hypnosis in the class. So I already had the skills of demonstrations and working with a large group of people. Mm-hmm. I just needed to put it in a package where I could, you know, present it in an entertaining way. So I rented a local bar there in Twin Falls, Idaho. It was called the Turf Club. I rented it out for two nights and just put up flyers everywhere. And I think I put an ad in the paper. And I hired some local guy to run my sound, and my mother took tickets at the door. And we sold it out both nights. I mean, it was completely packed. So that was, you know, when I first began doing stage hypnosis, and I enjoyed it so much, I just said, you know what, I got to keep doing this. And so then I started working in other nightclubs around Twin Falls and around Idaho. And then people were coming to me from Salt Lake City to take my hypnosis training courses. So I would teach those on the weekends, and I'd have my clinic that I'd run, you know, 5 days a week, plus having my kids in school and teaching at college at night and doing classes on weekends. So I was busy. And I began to have so many people coming from Salt Lake City, I said, you know what, I'm just going to go to Salt Lake and move there, because yeah, that's where the money was. You know, you're making $20,000, $30,000 a weekend. You might as well go where there's even more money. Mm-hmm. So that's what I did. So I moved to Salt Lake City and opened up another clinic down there. I opened up a school. Actually pissed off a lot of people is what I did, because back in that day you had two organizations, the National Guild and the American Council of Hypnotist Examiners. 30 hours one weekend to become a hypnotherapist with NGH, and with the other group it was 150 hours. I said, that's not enough. So I opened a school with 700 hours of hypnotherapy training.
Yeah, that's a good thing, actually.
Yeah, it was. It's a very good thing, but the organizations didn't like it. They got mad at me, and I'm glad. Because my position was, you know, if you're going to be a therapist, I think you should be smart. I think you should have a little bit of education. I think you should know a little bit about sociology, religion, philosophy. You know, have some, you know, some world views, you know, more than just outside of your neighborhood, which is where I find a lot of hypnotherapists come from in their training.
Right.
And I don't think that's a very brilliant idea. So anyway, and I had my school registered with the state of Utah as a post-secondary proprietary school, which means that I could actually offer higher degrees the same way as a college can. And nobody else had ever done that at that time. So I was offering, you know, diplomas the same way if you went to a college or university. So it was pretty cool. So I did that for a while, and then again, I was getting burned out, but during that time, I was working at all the nightclubs around Salt Lake City and in Nevada, the casinos, and over in Wyoming and Montana and Idaho. And I developed this tour where I'd go around and do all these shows, and I did hundreds and hundreds of shows just working in nightclubs for years, and really had a great time. You know, I mean, working in nightclubs, and you had some fun times.
I'm sure you had some interesting times. So, and eventually, you took it worldwide, did you not?
Well, yeah, I did. What happened is that as I was doing my shows there, you know, in the Northwest, then a theater called me and asked me if I would do a show there. And I said, no, I don't want to, because it was in Salt Lake City, and it was, you know, typically who's going to come to the show there in a theater that's, you know, family-oriented, you know, mostly the Mormons. Not a bad thing, but for me, working in nightclubs, you know, I mean, I had a different style that didn't really project out there, you know, because all of a sudden I've got to watch the words that I use, I've got to watch some of the skits that I do, and I can't, you know, nobody can buy me a drink, so I had to.
In Utah.
Yeah, so I said, no, I'm not interested. They pursued me for about 3 months, and I remember one night I was watching Jay Leno, and he was, you know, doing the Tonight Show, right, back in the day, and he was talking about how he could do a certain presentation there for the national viewership. But then on weekends, he would go up to Vegas or the comedy clubs there in L.A. and let his hair down and get wild. And I thought, God, what's wrong with me? I need to stretch as an artist. That's it. You know, what am I locking myself in this thing for? So I went to the theater, and I talked to Art, and I said, you know what? You know, okay, I'll do it. I go, when do you want me to start? He goes, well, this weekend. And I go, so what I did, I had to reinvent my entire show. I reinvented everything that I did. I had to take it from what I was doing in a bar, and because I wanted to make it something that nobody had ever seen before ever in the world of entertainment with hypnosis. So I created a stage show that was a mixture of drama, comedy, rock and roll, like you're going to a concert, you know, with flashing lights and, you know, all sorts of special effects. And it was, it turned out good. So we did that for 320 weeks, and I got burned out doing that because it became like a weekly job.
Right.
And that's the early days of the internet, and people started seeing me, you know, from around the world, and I started getting, you know, calls from people worldwide. So I quit my weekly job and started traveling, you know, the international market, doing shows around the world and a lot of corporate gigs. So, and that's, you know, then I started training people to do what I did, and here we are now talking to you.
What would you say to people who are thinking of taking stage hypnosis? What would you want them to know?
Well, what do I want them to know?
Yeah, like what do you want them to know about? Well, about the lifestyle, the entertainment. What do you want them to know about it?
Not everybody's going to be good at it. You know, I mean, the truth is, a lot of people, they, you know, I guess it's more what can I teach them is what, yeah. I think maybe a better question is, because people come from, you know, all aspects. You got men, you got women, you know, young people, older people, all ages. I mean, not everybody's going to be good at it, but mm-hmm. a lot of people will. And so I teach anybody, because even if it's a bucket list, right. you know, do it. You know what I mean? Go out, have fun. You know, I've been surprised by some people who I thought probably weren't going to be very good, who are actually, you know, kicked ass, you know, really good. So I'm really surprised by that. And there's a lot of people in the industry today that their egos get so huge in this field that, you know, it makes me, you know, I just turn away from them.
Right. And so what about people like me? Because I'm not interested in going on the stage. What I'd actually like to be really effective at is going out and giving public presentations so that I can acquire business or speaking gigs or clients. So what's this like for them?
For the individuals, I get a lot of folks like that who just want to, you know, to up their skill set. So if you're looking to up your skill set to be able to demonstrate hypnosis more proficiently and to really read people, you know, like a book, I mean, mm-hmm. very, very quickly, you know, and how to get people into hypnosis quickly, how to, you know, put the bright stars and, you know, in your audience and get people just completely amazed and bedazzled very quickly, mm-hmm. then this is for you. If you want to, you know, make the opportunities that you have in giving presentations spicier, I'll teach you that. You're going to learn that.
Okay.
You're going to learn how to take one person, two people, three people, 100 people at a time and put them into hypnosis very quickly and do whatever you want. And that, you know, actually that impresses people.
Yes, it does, and which is exactly why I am taking it. So everybody, Dawn's going to be doing a 4-day training here in Toronto, centrally located close to downtown. It begins November 15th to the 18th, so make sure to block it off in your calendars. And the thing I want to mention is if you want to get the really good price, the early bird special, you have got to book it before October 1st. So thanks for being with us here today, Dawn, and I look forward to when you make it to Toronto.
Sure. Well, you know, one other thing too, if anybody has any questions, you know, they can ask you or they can, you know, find me on Facebook and just send me a message and ask me any questions.
Excellent. And we'll be posting the link. We'll be posting the link to sign up for your course as well.
Yeah. Well, you know, you're going to learn how to demonstrate hypnosis. You're going to learn how to do a complete hypnosis show. You're going to learn how to market your shows. Actually, one of the things that I find interesting is that when you take the class is that I'm going to teach you how to put together your first show, how to book your first show before you even leave the class that week.
And you'll have people booking their show too to make sure they follow through, right?
Yeah, because I want everybody to have a show booked, you know, during the class so that we can troubleshoot anything and help them, you know, walk through everything. So, you know, we'll find a venue, you know, make the contact, you know, because that's, for a lot of people, that's the hardest part. The easy part is learning how to do skits. Mm-hmm. The hardest part is getting the show. So once you get a showroom, say, 3 months out, you know, then you got 3 months, man. Go find a location. And then you've got 3 months to develop who you are.